Good evening, news readers. Tonight, you're going to have a great time. For all of you, 3 to 4 minutes is allocated to read the news. In the meantime, there'll be two role players. The Toastmaster for the day is Diseni, and the timer for the day is Rivindu. So, Diseni will call up your name, and then immediately I will start recording your presentation. I will allow you to share the screen, videos, etc. So when Rivindu shows you the green color cards at the 3rd minute, be mindful that you have only 2 more minutes to go. And when he shows you the red color, make it a point that you wind up it within a short period of time. All of you can say in the beginning, good evening. The TV channel is YLT TV channel, YLT TV channel. And you are going to read the news tonight. And by ending the news, you can say good night. See you tomorrow at the same time. I hope it is clear.
Hello, everyone. So I hope that you guys are ready to be a news reader today. So let's jump onto the session. So the first announcer is Yashan Dulwatte. And now I invite Yashan Dulwatte to go live.
Good morning, this is Yashan Dulwatte from YLT TV channel. I'll be talking about current affairs gaming news, specifically E3 2021. This is Halo Infinite. This is game due holiday 2021. Produced by 343 Industries. The multiplayer is free to play. It contains references and options from old games, but modernized to make it feel fresh to old players and fun for new players. And it has given many old-timing Halo fans some hope after the terrible graphics in the last demo. The next game release is Jurassic World Evolution 2. Its use date is coming 2021. It features various aquatic reptiles and pterosaurs such as Dimosaurus. It adds a wildness weapon which allows the player to control and neutralize wild dinosaurs. And as a reference to Jurassic World Dominion, it has more than 75 species of prehistoric creatures and a lot of biomes, as you can see, a tundra and alpine in the entrance, and that's the new dinosaurs like Amosaurus, Sinosaurus, and such. And then the video. It's the biggest game in Nansenity.
This year's campus announcement.
That's it. Now over to you. Good night.
So the next announcer of the day is Jinuka. So now I would like to invite Jinuka to go ahead and go live.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to YLT News Daily. My name is Jinuka Hinkender. Today's headlines are on sale 125 balloon trips to the edge of the space. A Florida company is planning to fly passengers to the edge of the space in a high-tech version of a hot air balloon with a pilot and up to 8 travelers riding in a pressurized capsule suspended from an enormous blimp. Human space flight company Space Perspective is now taking resolutions on the spaceship Neptune for flights in early 2024, with tickets priced firmly in once-in-a-lifetime bracket at $125,000 per person. The refundable reservation deposits are higher, with higher down payments needed for year one flight and decreasing for later bookings. The inaugural test flight took off on June 18 from Space Course Spaceport in Tisville, Florida. The 6-hour and 39-minute flight was uncrewed, but cameras on board captured a stunning image of the Earth's surface. Space Perspective says the test flight is a crucial milestone on its way to taking space tourists on leisurely sightseeing jaunts with refreshing bar social media capabilities to hand. This spaceship it will be sold in 2024. Only a billionaire can take that. That's the news for today, and good night. Thank you.
The next announcer for today is Thisumi. So now I would like to invite Thisumi to go live.
Hello everyone. Welcome to Asia World News. I'm Thisumi Jayaram. The Singapore registered express pearl ship had been on fire for 2 weeks near Colombo Port. The express pearl ship had been carrying 1,486 containers, which has 25 tons of nitric acid and other chemicals such as copper and lead and sodium dioxide and other cosmetics and plastic raw materials. Due to this incident, millions of plastic raw materials of shopping bags had reached Sri Lanka's coastline. And there were tiny round pieces of plastic raw materials that washed up to the beaches. Those plastic raw materials can be called as noodles, which can produce all the plastic goods nearly. And it will be take time between 500 to 1000 to decompose those plastics. And as the result of the fire on the ship, a massive damage caused to local marine ecosystem. And the most long lasting impact is the chemical pollution. It will be affect all the countries for decades. And small fishes might die like as the result of poisoning. And fishes, turtles, and dolphins have already washed up to the beaches. The Sri Lankan environmental specialists say that the most dangerous elements are the sodium dioxide, copper, and the lead. Those chemicals are very harmful for local marine system. Further, they say that in future also, the fishes will be contaminated with these chemicals and this bioaccumulation will be a serious problem. This means fish from the area will be dangerous, not only from now, it will be affected in the future also. As the ship was being pulled out to the sea, things went from bad to worse. That is why it is called worst marine disaster in Sri Lanka. And the fishing community is badly affected. Fishing has been banned in the affected areas. Many of them have lost their income. All the breeding ground of the fish are destroyed as of the chemical pollution. Acid rains may occur near future. Good night. See you tomorrow.
The next announcer for today is Chantul. So now I would like to invite Chantul to go live.
I'm Chantul Pereira from YLT TV channel, Buddhist section. Headlines for today. State ceremony for Possum Poet is celebrated in Mihinthale. Chantul Pereira and team of Royal College performs for Possum in Rupavahini. LTT prisoners given presidential pardon. Now, news in detail. Possum Poya is an annual festival held in Sri Lanka, which is celebrated by the Buddhists. This is one of the most important Poya Day for the Sri Lankans because of the arrival of Buddhism on such a day. Buddhism was brought by Bihidu Maharaja Thero, the son of Emperor Ashoka in India. The state Possum Poya ceremony was held today at Mihinthale Rajamaha Vihare. Our news reporter from Anuradhapura reports that President Gotabaya Rajapaksa arrived at Mihinthale to mark the Possum ceremony. The state event was organized by adhering to strict medical guidelines. The Rupavahini TV channel telecasted the best performed song of Royal College. Dhanno Budunge song was performed by the students of 7H of Royal College. Chantu Pereira performed with the violin, which added more glamour to the song. This was shown in the Sindhu Kochia program in the Rupavahini TV channel. Today, President granted presidential pardon to 16 LTTE suspects who had served jail sentence for well over 10 years. And commenting on the release of the LTTE prisoners, the Buddhist clergy said that they welcome such a move by the president on this Possum Poya day. They went on the saying that Sri Lanka, being a Buddhist country, the people should not look at it in a negative way, and quoted the Buddhist teacher, Nahi Verana Verani, which means hatred ceases not by hatred, but by love. So that's all for today. And we will meet tomorrow with more news. Have a meaningful Possum Poya evening. I am Chantu Pereira with YLT TV channel Buddhist section. Thank you.
The next announcer for today's session is Sinadi. So now I would like to invite Sinadi to go live.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to YLT News at 7 p.m. I'm Sinidhi Gunasekara. And let's start off with the stories which are making headlines. A new highly contagious Delta variant has been found in Sri Lanka. It is said that this COVID variant spreads faster than the UK's Alpha COVID-19 variant. People are raging over the price increase of fuel and different food. More and more sea creatures washed ashore in the Express Pearl disaster aftermath. The new COVID-19 Delta variant has been detected in Sri Lanka. Two individuals have been first detected with the Indian Delta COVID-19 variant in the country. Officials have said that this variant has not yet entered our community, and the two individuals have been sent to quarantine centers. But in recent tests, they have found that five more individuals have been contracted to this variant. The people infected with this variant show different symptoms than the original variant. For an example, let's take the past symptoms as cough, fever, and loss of taste and smell in food. These are the cardinal symptoms of COVID-19, but associated with the Delta variant, increasingly found as headaches, sore throat, and runny nose are the most commonly found symptoms which are affected to the people affected in the Delta variant. It is said that it spreads 50% faster than the Alpha variant. The main problem is one vaccine dose isn't effective towards Delta. So our human immune system has a fighting chance towards Delta if we get both doses. It is also said that this Delta virus is the most fast spreading variant and the most harmful variant out of all of the COVID variants. As of today, there are 2,196 new cases of COVID-19 from the last 24 hours and 65 deaths in the last 24 hours too. So it totals up to 246,109 total confirmed COVID cases and 2,787 total deaths and 211,186 recovered people from this virus. So this is all of the news for today. Hope you have a great night. Good night, everyone, and see you tomorrow.
The next announcer of today's session is Setumbi. So now I invite Setumbi to go live.
Hello everyone, this is Adhidharan. I'm Setumbi Vijayagunavarayan. Nowadays, COVID-19 in Sri Lanka is way more worse. It's 246,109 and the active cases is 30,515. The new reports is 2,196. The people who has been recovered and discharged is 212,225. The number of deaths is 2,769. Due to the New Year celebration, people kept on visiting their relatives until their celebration ends. So due to this, the COVID-19 spread on April. So we call this wave as the COVID-19. As you said, at home, and it's difficult for people to find jobs and have food. People have to live according to the precautions the WHO says. The precautions are to wear a mask whenever you go out. It's a really important thing for you to do. and to wash your hands frequently with soap and water. Do not touch your eyes with dirty hands, because COVID-19 goes through eyes, nose, and mouth. Use a tissue when coughing or sneezing. But if you don't have a tissue, you can bend your elbow and then cough or sneeze. As Mr. Shravendra Silva says about COVID-19, that people had to take care of themselves and had to know what kind of period they are in right now. And so many doctors say that the people who has non-communicable diseases such as diabetes and etc. has to stay home and never go out because their immunity systems are really weak, especially for old people. As the president says about COVID-19, that we have three options to face this pandemic. First is to lock down the entire country. Second is not to COVID-19. Third is that we have to opt to this. Now, this news will end right now. Good night. Have a nice day.
The next announcer for today's session is Vimandi. So now I would like to invite Vimandi to go live.
Hello everyone, this is I'm welcoming you to the night sports section of the news at 7 p.m. First, let me get to the headline. There was a cricket match a few hours ago, England versus Sri Lanka. It was a straight win to England with 132 total wickets, while Sri Lanka lost to 129 to 7 wickets. Over by over commentary and in play clips from the first T20 international between England and Sri Lanka at Cardiff watch live on Sky Sports Cricket. England won the whole match by 8 wickets, and really Sri Lanka never really got to grips with the variation and control of the England attacks. And you can also watch the full video on Sky Sports Cricket, and also you can watch it in the TV. High match with really bad conditions for Sri Lanka, as England won. It was England took the whole lead all of a sudden just as they started. And it was a really bad spot for Sri Lanka. And now, thank you for joining. Already with me, Thomas Jones.
The next announcer of today's session is Ravinu. So now I would like to invite Ravinu to go live.
Good evening, everyone. I am from YLT News Channel. And today is 24th of June, 2021. I have three headlines to overcome my news. The first one is Justice's rule against NCCA limits on some school perks for student athletes. Next, here you can see CNN News Channel is celebrating their 25th anniversary. And this is the latest news. And in the last day, it is the first time ICC World Test Championship in India versus New Zealand. Starting from this, the NCC has contested law court ruling that would allow colleagues to often greater academic related to football and basketball players benefits for their scholarships for their education. And coming on to this, on this news, this news is more valuable for the basketball and football players. And this is also a latest news, CNN News Channel. Worldwide news channel in America has celebrated their 25th anniversary. And finally, the ICC 2021 World Test Championship. And it has held in England, Southampton. But you all know when it is test match, it has only held up to 5 days. But this test match is held up to 6 days because of the rain, and this match has won by New Zealand, and they are the champions of test final in 2021. And that's all for today. See you tomorrow. Thank you.
The next announcer is Mithuli. So now I invite Mithuli to go live.
Yes, sir. Good evening. Welcome to YLT Daily. I am Mithuli Hinkembe, and now let's hear the top stories today. 2020 Summer Olympics scheduled on coming July. The 2020 Summer Olympics that was supposed to be on last summer, which were unfortunately postponed due to the COVID-19 pandemic, are back on. The Summer Olympic Games are scheduled on 8th August. The Paralympic Games are between 24th of August and 5th September. The Olympics involve 33 competitions and 339 events held across 42 venues. The Paralympics feature 539 events across 22 sports at 21 venues. Most events are to be in Greater Tokyo area. Nevertheless, some football games and the marathon are scheduled to be in Sapporo in Hokkaido, which also is a state of emergency. The 2020 president, Seiko Hashimoto, says that it is 100% certain the games will go on ahead despite the state of emergency in the city. Also, varied COVID measures are also in place for these Olympics. In fact, Japan's borders are shut to foreigners, so no international fans can travel the games. International athletes and support staff will be tested before departure and on arrival in Japan. They won't necessarily have to quarantine, but must stay in bubbles and avoid mixing with the locals. However, Team Great Britain athletes may have to quarantine after the UK was added to Japan's red travel list because of the rising cases of Delta variant. All UK arrivals, including support staff and members of media, will have immediately self-isolated for 6 days. Tokyo 2020 has said no more exceptions will be made for athletes, but Team Great Britain says it hopes to resolve the situation. Also, a recent poll in the leading Asahi Shimbun newspaper suggested more than 18% of the population wants the country wants the games either cancelled or postponed. Several towns set to host the athletes have reportedly pulled out over fears it could spread COVID and put pressure on the healthcare system. Also, protests to stop occurring of the Olympic Games can be seen in the country. In May, a doctors' union told the government it was impossible to hold the games given the pandemic, and the Asahi Shimbun called for them to be cancelled. Nevertheless, the Olympic Games can only be cancelled under very exceptional circumstances like war or civil disorder. However, no major countries have spoken out against the games. The US issued a travel warning for Japan following the surge, but officials said they are confident their athletes will take part. Team Great Britain remains fully committed to send out our full team to the Tokyo Olympic Games. Chinese President Xi Jinping has also pledged his support. China is due to host the next Winter Games in February 2022. And that's all the news for tonight. Thank you. That's good night. Have a nice day.
The next announcer of today's session is Dinuki. So now I invite Dinuki to go live. The next announcer is Nethaya. So now I would like to invite Nethaya to go live.
Good evening. Sir, can I start again? Good evening. I'm Netha Bandara from YLT News. Ranil Wickremesinghe, the leader of the United National Party, sworn in as a member of parliament today, 23rd June 2021. He did his inaugural speech in this parliament soon after he was sworn in. Mr. Wickremesinghe elected to the parliament for the first time in 1977. Since then, Mr. Wickremesinghe continuously got elected to the parliament for the last 44 years. Mr. Wickremesinghe held the office of Prime Minister for 5 instances. He was the youngest minister in 1977 during J.R. Jayawardena government. Mr. Ranil Wickremesinghe is considered as of the senior and experienced politicians in the Asian region. Thank you.
Next, I would like to invite Sankar to go live. The next announcer for today's session is Dinky. So now I would like to invite Dinky to go live.
Bringing you the news from across Sri Lanka and around the world. Bringing you the news from across Sri Lanka and around the world, live from Senico News Channel, Colombo. Good evening and welcome to the news at 7. I am Dinky Senaratne. science for tonight. Samagi Balavegya demonstrate protest at Parliament. Travel restrictions has been imposed yesterday night. COVID-19 cases has been reported yesterday. Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine for the school children. Sri Lanka celebrating Poson Poya today. Parliamentarians of Samagi Balavegya protested in the Parliament chamber by demanding fuel price reduction. They highlighted government must provide the relief to the people during this pandemic situation. Travel restrictions has been imposed from 10 p.m. yesterday and will be lifted once again at 4 a.m. on 25th June. 1,358 COVID-19 cases has been reported yesterday. Total cases up to yesterday, 245,271. According to the Ministry of Health, 209,296 people have recovered from the infection and deaths has been reported 2,704 at yesterday. Pediatrician Dr. Suranta Pereira said, Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine must be vaccinated to the school students. Pfizer vaccine has been past the trial stage and has been vaccinated to the children in the developed countries. He said, we must develop a vaccination strategy before we open the school. Once the schools reopen, it is very important to continue the school operation without closing again. However, according to the discussions, some schools will be reopened on the August or first week of September, depending on the country situation. Today, Sri Lankan Buddhist people are celebrating Poson Poya by remembering the arrival of Buddhism through Mihindu Mahathero. This time, most of the ceremonies had been cancelled due to pandemic situation. Now it's time to wrap the primetime news. I am Dinaki Sirnaratna. Take care, stay safe, good night.
The next announcer of today's session is Sanukar. So now I would like to invite Sanukar to go live. Now I would like to invite Sansita to go live.
Hello and welcome back to PS News. Now we are going to sports news. I am Sansita Mayadum from PS News. Today is 24th of June. Today main news is Test Championship. So the first Test Championship is goes to New Zealand cricket team. They won by India. The first ICC Test World Cup final match was started on 8th of June and it ended on 3rd of June. The tournament was started on 1st of August 2019. But some matches are late and some matches are not able to play with this COVID-19 pandemic. The first match was played by Sri Lanka and South Africa. When we moving on to the final match yesterday, it is held at Russell World Ground. England and New Zealand are able to participate for this final match. Match has some disturbance with climbing. The most runs taken in the tournament is Maunus from New Zealand. Most wicket taken is Ravi Chandran from India. World Cup. Now we can move on to World Cup points table. First place is India with 520 points. Second place is New Zealand with 420 points. Third place is Australia with 332 points. Fourth place is England with 442 points. So this is the first ICC Test Cricket World Cup. It is won by New Zealand cricket team. Also, they have another special moment. This is the first time that New Zealand have won an ICC World Cup match. So that's all for today's sport news. See you tomorrow night.
Now, I would like to invite Nimsita to go live.